Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pi My Life Up. In this video, we'll be showing you how to set up a NUT server on your Raspberry Pi. NUT, or Network UPS Tools, is a project aimed at providing support for UPS devices. This allows you to interact with them and get information such as their current charge. Using a Raspberry Pi as a NUT server is a great choice as it's a low-powered device. Other devices then can read the status of the UPS from your server without needing to be directly connected to it. This can be incredibly useful as most UPSs only provide a single data output. But if you have multiple devices connected, there's a high chance you want multiple of them to actually properly shut down before the UPS powers itself off. For this tutorial, we highly recommend using Raspberry Pi OS Lite. It's also a perfect place to utilize a more low-powered Raspberry Pi, such as the Raspberry Pi 02W. Once you're ready to proceed, connect to your Raspberry Pi over SSH or connect directly to it and use the terminal. Before we get started, let's ensure our Raspberry Pi OS is up to date. First part of this process is to update the package list by typing in sudo apt update. Once the update completes, upgrade any out-of-date packages by typing in sudo apt upgrade-y. Once the upgrade is completed, we can now proceed with installing NUT onto your Raspberry Pi. To install the NUT server, all you need to do is type in sudo apt install NUT and press enter. If prompted, press Y and hit enter to continue with the installation. With NUT now installed, we need to configure it so your Raspberry Pi can actually communicate with your connected UPS. For this guide, we will be assuming that your UPS will connect over USB. For NUT to identify the correct USB device to connect to, we will need to get two particular ID values. To retrieve these, type in LSUSB into the terminal and press enter. You'll now get a list of USB devices that are currently connected to your Raspberry Pi. Use this to identify your connected UPS. In our case, you can see our CyberPower UPS is connected. The values we need to configure NUT are located just after the ID identifier. You'll want to write these numbers down as you'll need them later on in this guide. The value on the left side of the colon symbol is your vendor ID. The numbers on the right side of the colon are the product ID. Now we know the required values, we can begin editing the config file for NUT by typing in sudo nano /etc/nut/ups.conf. Now we want to scroll to the bottom of this file so we can define a new UPS for NUT to manage. To start a new UPS, type in open square bracket followed by a name to give your UPS. In our case, we'll be calling ours Pi NUT Mon. This name cannot contain any spaces or symbols. You will need to remember the name of this UPS as you will need to set it in a couple of other configuration files. Finish defining this new section with a closed square bracket. Next, we need to define the driver that NUT will use to communicate with your connected UPS. For most modern UPSs, you'll be able to use the USB HID-UPS driver like we are in this guide. To define this driver, type in driver space equals space USB HID-UPS. If this driver doesn't work for you, we recommend checking the compatibility page on the official Network UPS Tools website. With this done, on a new line, type in port space equals space auto. This tells NUT to automatically figure out what USB port on our Raspberry Pi to use to communicate with the UPS. Next, we must define the vendor ID of our UPS. To do this, type in vendor ID space equals followed by your unique identifier. In our case, that is 0764. Next, we must also set the product ID that we got earlier. To do this, type in product ID space equals followed by your unique identifier. From our example, this will be 0501. Now we can specify a description for this UPS. To do that, type in DESC space equals space double quote followed by a brief description of what this UPS is. For our example, we'll be typing Raspberry Pi NUT UPS monitor followed by a double quote to end the description. With that all done, we can now save and quit by pressing Ctrl plus X followed by Y and then enter. With that done, our next step is to set up the NUT server functionality of NUT. This NetFET server functionality allows other devices to connect to your Raspberry Pi to pull information about your UPS. The first part of this process is to adjust how the NAT server will actually listen. To open up Access, type in sudo space nano slash etc slash nut slash upsd.com. Now scroll to the bottom of this file and type in listen space 0.0.0.0 space 3493. This tells NAT to listen on all available addresses on your Raspberry Pi. With that done, save and quit by pressing Ctrl plus X, then Y, and then Enter. The next part of the setup process is to create a NAT user. To begin this process, type in sudo space nano slash etc slash NAT slash upsd.users. This file opens, scroll to the bottom, and begin defining a new user by typing an open square bracket, followed by a username for this user. In our case, we'll be calling ours UPS Monitor. Do not use spaces or symbols in this username. Finish off defining the new user by ending it with a closed square bracket. Underneath this user, we then want to define a password for them by typing in password, followed by the equal sign, followed by the password for your user. Next, we need to tell NAT whether this is monitoring primary or secondary UPSs. As this UPS is primary, as it's connected directly to your Raspberry Pi, you'll want to type in UPS mon space primary. With NAT, a secondary UPS is one that it is connecting to remotely over your network. Once everything is set, save and quit by pressing Ctrl plus X, Y, and then Enter. The next part of this process requires us to configure NAT to actually monitor our UPS using the user we just defined. To configure this, type in sudo space nano slash etc slash NAT slash upsmon.com. Now scroll to the bottom of this file and type in monitor all in uppercase, followed by the name of your UPS, which in our case was Pi NAT mon, followed by the at symbol, then localhost, followed by one, and then follow that up by typing in the name of your user you set up in the last steps. In our case, this is UPS monitor. Follow this up by specifying the password for your user. In our case, this is Pi My Life Up. Finally, type in primary so that NAT knows that the UPS it is monitoring is directly connected to your Raspberry Pi. Now save and quit by pressing Ctrl plus X followed by Y and then Enter. We are finally at the point where we can actually enable the NAT server functionality within NAT. To do this, we need to edit one final file by typing in sudo space nano space slash etc slash NAT slash NAT.com. Now scroll through this file until you see a line that says mode equals none. Now replace none with NAT server and then save and quit by pressing Ctrl plus X, then Y, and then Enter. All we need to do now is restart both the NAT server and the NAT monitor. You can restart this NAT server by typing in sudo systemctl space restart space NAT hyphen server. Next, restart the UPS monitor by typing in sudo systemctl space restart space NAT hyphen monitor. With everything now set up, we can finally use NAT to communicate with our connected UPS. To test this functionality, we'll use this command line interface. To get the status of your UPS, type in UPSC space followed by the name you assigned to your UPS. For our example, this will be Pi NAT mon. You should now see a wealth of information about your UPS. This includes the input voltage, the current charge status, as well as much more. The amount of information displayed to you will depend on both the brand of UPS you are using as well as the model. In our case, we are using a UPS from CyberPower. If you have forgotten what you named your UPS monitors, you can always type in UPSC space hyphen capital L. This will give you a list of all the UPSs you are monitoring through your Raspberry Pi. On the left hand side, you'll see the name you assigned this UPS, followed by the description. At this point, you have successfully set up NAT on your Raspberry Pi to monitor a UPS. If you have a remote client, all you need to do is point it to your Raspberry Pi's IP address and use the username and password you set up earlier in this guide. You can take things a step further by setting up NAT's web interface. This web interface allows you to quickly view the status of any connected UPS. It isn't required to use NAT, but it can be a useful way for quickly checking on things. To begin setting this up, type in sudo space app space install space Apache 2 followed by nut-cgi. If prompted, type in Y and press Enter to continue with the installation of these key pieces of software. Once the Apache web server and the nut-cgi software has been installed, we now need to make more changes to nut's configuration. In particular, we need to modify the host's configuration file. This file controls what UPSs are available through nut's web interface. Begin configuring this file, type in sudo space nano space slash etc slash nut slash hosts.conf and pressing enter. Now scroll to the bottom of this file. Once at the bottom, define a new monitor by typing in monitor space followed by the name of the UPS you want displayed in the web interface, in our case pynotmon, followed by the at symbol, followed by localhost, followed by a double quote, then a brief description of your UPS. In our case, we'll type in pi power monitor, followed by another double quote. This description is used within the nut web interface. Once you're done, press Ctrl plus X, then Y, and then Enter to save and quit. Our next step is to enable the CGI functionality of Apache by typing in sudo a2enmod CGI. With this module now enabled, we will need to restart Apache by typing in sudo space system ctl space restart space Apache 2. With Apache now restarted, you'll be able to access the nut web interface that is running on your Raspberry Pi. To access this web interface, go to http://, followed by the IP of your Raspberry Pi, which in our case is 192.168.0.34, followed by /cgi-bin/nut/upstats.cgi and pressing enter. You'll now see a quick status of your UPS, including the battery percentage, the input voltage, the output voltage, and the overall load. If you want to see more information, simply click the name of your UPS in the left-hand column. At this point, you have successfully set up Nut on your Raspberry Pi to monitor your UPS. If you like this tutorial, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.